I'm Dr. Trina Blythe, and I'm here to talk to you today about the upcoming cold and flu season. Every year, colds and flus start circulating in the fall and continue well into the late spring. This year, COVID-19 will continue to circulate as well, and we're going to also see adenovirus, enterovirus, bacteria like strep, influenza, and four lesser known coronaviruses. So what can you do to keep yourself safe during this sick season? Well, I have 5 tips for you today. Number 1, get yourself and your children a flu shot. Why do I recommend a flu shot? Well, there's many benefits to the influenza vaccine. First and foremost, people who have the influenza vaccine are at much lower risk for getting influenza. And when you do get influenza, if you've already had the vaccine, chances are you're going to have a much milder illness. 2 other benefits to the influenza vaccine is that it will reduce the spread of influenza in the community and help protect our most vulnerable members. And reducing the spread of influenza in the community also means less hospitalizations from influenza and a lower burden on our healthcare system, which will already be very taxed this year due to COVID-19. Number 2, I'm recommending that we continue our social distancing, wearing masks, excellent hand washing, and sanitizing of high contact surfaces. Why am I recommending this? Well, we've already seen that these practices help reduce the spread of COVID-19. So it's a no-brainer to think that it would help reduce the spread of influenza and colds as well. Number 3, support good health for yourself and your children by getting regular well checkups, making healthy food choices, such as eating fresh fruits and vegetables, getting adequate sleep, and reducing stress. Many parents were afraid to bring in their children for well checkups during the COVID-19 pandemic. But rest assured, pediatricians are making many strides to make sure that their office is a safe place to bring children into. And the importance of getting well checkups means that children will stay up to date on their vaccinations, get critical medical and developmental screenings that are more effective when done on time. Number 4, if you're sick, stay home. If your child is sick, keep them home. Why am I recommending this? Well, long gone are the days of toughing it out and going to work or school or sports when you're still sick. And by staying home, you'll do 2 things. You'll help reduce the spread of infection in the community, and you will also give your body the chance it needs to get better. Number 5, call your pediatrician if your child is sick, or call your doctor if you're sick. Why? Well, COVID-19, influenza, and colds are gonna have a lot of overlapping symptoms. So you will want the advice of a medical professional to help you navigate these waters. And you want to continue to stay home and get rest and feel better. And using the advice of your pediatrician will help you do that. So in summary, my 5 tips were: 1, get your flu shot. 2, continue your social distancing and your masking. 3, maintain and support good health by getting regular checkups. 4, stay home if you're sick. And 5, keep those lines of communication that are so crucial open between your child's doctor and your own doctor.